My name is Scott. I am a sinner. Grew up in a Christian home, going to church and going to youth group and everything. I got married, attended this church for quite a few years, and then we decided we needed to move to Madrid. Went to Slater Church, and it was that time when things started to go the wrong way. Had an adulterous affair with a woman for 3 years. At that point in time, my wife decided that she was done with me, and so she just left, and after that day, God grabbed a hold of my heart and said, you need to go talk to some people. So I went and talked to some men of this church and Pastor Kevin, and we set up some counseling meetings for myself. And about 2 weeks after we started, he had his attack. Satan decided to grab a hold of him. So I didn't quite know what I was going to do, but I knew that God was in control. And through the Engage Network here, Pastor Andy was able to take charge of Pastor Kevin's duties while he was out, and it was through Pastor Andy that in the counseling sessions that I was starting to learn some things. And one day he asked me what my testimony was, and I really couldn't give him a testimony. It was a couple of days later, I was driving to work, and I was listening to Focus on the Family. Sherry Rose Shepherd was actually on there talking about things, and she was at an abortion conference, and the people there did not know she had one, but the people asked her if she could speak on that. She said, well, I can't do that right now. I need to go talk to my 10-year-old son. She went and talked to her 10-year-old son, and told him that she had had an abortion before him, and he just started crying uncontrollably. And she asked him, why are you crying? He said, someday I'll get to go to heaven and see my brother or sister. It was at that point in time that I couldn't honestly say that I would go to heaven and see my family. At that point in time that God had a hold of my heart. So fortunately it was that Friday that I got to go meet with Pastor Kevin or Pastor Andy, and I'd been studying in John chapter 3. John chapter 3 verses 19 through 21 says, this is the verdict. Light has come into the world, but people love darkness rather than light because their deeds were evil. Everyone who does evil hates the light and will not come into it for fear that their deeds will be exposed. But whoever lives by the truth comes into the light so that it may be plainly seen that what they have done has been done in the sight of God. In that meeting, I read through there and I told Pastor Andy, I said, that's me right there. I said, I need God in my heart.
So that's the day that you put your trust in Christ then?
That was the day that I decided that all my pride was gone. I was done with being in control, and God had control of my life right there.
Amen. We praise the Lord for that, Scott, very much. It just shows that you can be in a church for a better part of your life and still not really know the Lord. Right. And yet through the difficult circumstances, God brought it about to help you realize that, and you put your trust in Christ. Yep. Has your life changed since then?
Greatly.
So, greatly. You read the Word some?
Every day.
Every day? You share the Lord with other people?
Sure do.
Amen. Amen. That's a great change, Scott. And let's just pray for you right now. Father, we thank you for Scott. And as we think of the difficult circumstances that he went through to find you, we give thanks that he found you, or you found him. And Father, we're thankful that his trust is in Christ now, that he has a new life. And Father, I pray that you would richly bless him and his family. We just pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Scott, here, I'll let you hold on to that. Because of your testimony in the Lord Jesus Christ and your faith, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.